This video is about to make a lot of you very happy. The new Ubiquiti Dream Router is finally here. Ubiquiti has been on a tear in the first weeks of 2025, and now the conversion to 2.5 gigabit Ethernet ports is almost complete. This is the brand new Dream Router 7, and it was announced this morning alongside the UniFi Express 7, as well as the Cloud Gateway Fiber this morning. The Dream Router 7, or as I like to call the R2-D2 form factor, has been greatly anticipated by lots of folks who love the previous generation of the Dream Router, but haven't been able to get their hands on it, or have wanted upgraded internals for a long time. The Dream Router, now 3 years old, was looking a little long in the tooth as we saw releases such as the Cloud Gateway Max and Ultra, as well as the rest of the UniFi lineup, bringing them to 2.5 gigabit and 10 gigabit connections. But rest assured, that day has arrived, and now enough chit-chat, let's get to the actual device. On the back, this will look a little bit different to you. The Dream Router 7 now has all 2.5 gigabit switch ports, only one PoE port, the first one up top, and a brand new 10 gig SFP plus port. The SFP port is mapped to WAN, but you can remap it to LAN if you wanted to use it with a DAC cable to send 10 gigabit connection downstream. You'll notice that the SD card slot has been moved down below the SFP port, and when you pop it out, you'll see that it comes with a 64 gig Western Digital Purple SD card, which is perfectly rated to be able to work for things like UniFi Protect running on here for a handful of cameras. On the bottom, we have the power input, and of course, up on top is our Wi-Fi 7 access point, including 6 gigahertz Wi-Fi. One thing I forgot to mention is, as before, you also get the reset button on the bottom of the device. Nice clicky sound. All in all, making this a very powerful, compact, all-in-one desktop or mobile, business-class network, Wi-Fi, and possibly cameras, phones, you name it, device. I've been playing with this for a little while, and I have used the PoE port up top to power things such as phone, Wi-Fi, and of course even cameras. Now, if you want to power all this at once, I recommend plugging in a switch so that you can have enough ports to power everything downstream, because only the top port is PoE. Now, this is different to the previous generation, where the bottom two ports were PoE. Unfortunately, they decided to take one of those away this time. What I've always loved about the Dream Router form factor is the fact that you can pick and choose the different apps that you want to run. Now, you are only technically able to run three apps on here, but with Network, Protect, and Talk, for example, unless you wanted to do signage or access control, you don't really need much else. Now, this is designed generally for a small to mid-size office or a mobile office, somebody on the go that wants an all-in-one package. And generally, those are not the types that are going to be doing access control, or maybe they're not doing talk, and you can pick and choose which ones you want to do with your setup. All right, I've got it plugged in, booted up, and plugged in. I recently upgraded my internet in the studio to 2.5 gig, and so that's plugged directly into the back here. I'm not currently using the SFP cable in the back, but that's because I don't have one long enough to go back to my test rack over there. You should be able to see here the little screen, and I'll include B-roll of this, of course, which, just like its previous version, goes and tells you what clients are connected and the speed on the device. I currently have a phone. This is the new G3 Touch Pro phone connected to it, with the wireless handset, of course. And the reason for that is because, given that this is a small office setup, it's perfect for those who are working at home but want to be able to have a dedicated, reliable, controllable, configurable connection, as opposed to just whatever crap your internet provider gives you. I've even gone as far as deploying some of these, sending these out already pre-configured to some of my clients. They plug it in, I walk them through a couple of things on site, and they're up and running. They've got the phone, they've got the Wi-Fi, they've got the network, it's all set up. I can control it remotely, and that's what they use for their business connection. Having the phone running alongside, either powered by it or powered through another PoE switch, is a very easy to set up, simple to use system for somebody who is not necessarily so tech savvy and just wants a system that they can plug in and have it work. Another way that you could do this is, of course, cameras. You could have a wired camera plugged directly into the PoE port in order to get power and network connectivity to it. But because it's Wi-Fi and it's running Protect, you could also run things such as the G4 Instant Camera, for example. You could even go as far as connect a device bridge wirelessly to this and then power a PoE camera from there. Lastly, if all you need is extended Wi-Fi, you could run a long Ethernet cable from here to the other end of your office or home office, plug in your AP, and run the whole thing off of the single connection here. Super easy. Now, compared with the original Dream Router, which is this one over here, this is the new Dream Router 7, and this is the original Dream Router, they are the same size, although obviously they look a little bit different given the rearrangement of the ports on the back of the Dream Router 7. The Dream Router 7 has 1 more gig of RAM, bringing it up to 3 gig total. The processor is upgraded from a dual-core ARM Cortex-A53 at 1.35 gigahertz to the quad-core version at 1.5 gigahertz. As mentioned before, the Ethernet ports on the back are upgraded from 1 gigabit Ethernet to 2.5 gigabit Ethernet. You could, of course, use the SFP port for your WAN connection and remap the WAN Ethernet port to another LAN as part of the switch if you wanted to. And of course, you can switch that around, vice versa. You can use the SFP for a 10 gigabit connection, say, to a NAS or something similar, and then continue using the 2.5 gig switch for your internet connection. On the Wi-Fi side, you get 4x4 MIMO across 2.4, 5 gigahertz, and now 6 gigahertz ranges. The throughput increases on 2.4 gigahertz from 600 megabits per second to 688 megabits per second, which is a small increase. However, the larger increases come on the higher bands. On 5 gigahertz, you go from 2.4 gigabits per second to 4.3 gigabits per second. And now with the new model, it adds in the 6 gigahertz range with a throughput rate of 5.7 gigabits per second. All right, now that it's all powered up and connected, let's switch over to Wi-Fi Man on my Pixel 9 Pro Fold and see what we get. Here we go. 9 millisecond latency, not bad. Oh baby, 1,772 meg down, 1,370 up. Let's run this again. I always like to do this twice. I always like to do this a few times. All right, looking good, climbing, 1,500. 1430, give or take, 1500, upload, 1700, 18, oh baby. Not bad, 1400 up and down over Wi-Fi. I'm very happy with that speed. One thing that was missing from the previous version and this version that I would really love to see is something that they teased us with, an image on the website showing off a non-existent but seemingly theoretical transparent version of this, which just looks super cool, and I love transparent tech, so Ubiquiti, please make a transparent version of this. That is my main piece of feedback. That would be amazing. And even when I was ready to retire it, it would still sit on the shelf as a museum piece because it just looks so awesome. I love transparent tech. You get to see the internals. It's awesome. Ubiquiti, please make that happen. I'm not going to go through the interface on this because it's the same as any of the other Ubiquiti gateways. I'll save that for another video. Dream Router 7 costs $299 and is available today and will likely sell like hotcakes given how much people love these things. If this video was helpful for you, I'd appreciate it if you could use my affiliate link down below to make your purchase, as we do get a small commission. If you have questions and comments, I'm happy to keep the conversation going and answer as many as I can. Please drop them down below. And as always, thanks for watching. No, these are not new Ubiquiti bongos.